Hello student, in last video we came to know what are the applications of Lee Chatelier principle. Now let us discuss. Here we have the definition of electrolytes and non-electrolytes. Okay, further we have topics electrolytes and non-electrolytes. Here how can you define the electrolyte is means, okay, a substance whose aqueous solution conduct an electric current. Okay, what is the meaning of means? For example, okay, if you see here, sodium chloride is there, okay, this is a salt. One dissolves in the water, okay. Aqueous solution means what? Any salt, any compound, if dissolve in the water, that is called as a what? Aqueous solution, okay. Now, that aqueous solution conduct what? Electric current, that is called as a what? Electrolyte. For example, here we took the electrolyte solution of what? Sodium chloride. Sodium chloride, once you dissolve in the water, what happens? Going to dissociate as a what? One sodium chloride here. Once dissolves in the water, what happens? It is going to dissociate as a what? Na plus and Cl minus ions. You are getting the cations, anions. Okay. Nothing but simply what happens? Sodium is going to lose electron and chloride is taking the electron. Why? Because means this is less electronegativity. This is what? Chlorine is more electronegativity. So flow of electron, nothing but you can call as a what? Electricity. So sodium chloride, when dissolves in the water, it conducts the electricity. Okay, now so it is a definition of what? Electrolyte. Now discuss about the non-electrolyte. Okay, opposite to electrolyte. Here what is the definition of non-electrolyte? A substance whose aqueous solution does not conduct what? An electric current. Okay, here we have the example one. Here if you aqueous solution of sugar, nothing but sugar, if you dissolve in the water, what happen? It does not dissociate into ions. You can see here we have the positive negative charges are there, isn't it? But here we don't have any charges. Okay, that type of molecule or that type of compounds called as what? Non-electrolytes. Okay, electrolyte means simply they are going to conduct the electricity. Here non-electrolyte means what happened? There does not aqueous solution means again what? One dissolves in the water, that is called as a what? Aqueous solution. So sugar, here once dissolved in the water, it is not going to conduct an electric current, that is called as a what? Non-electrolyte. Okay, now let us see the examples for the electrolyte. Okay, here for all you know need, just remember strong acid, strong base, salts. What is a strong acid, strong base? That we will discuss later. Here means all what are the compounds, here we have the example, they are going to divide as a what? They are going to dissociate as a plus ion minus. Simply you are going to get the what? Cations, anions. So all are, these are the examples for the what? Electrolytes. Now let us see the example for the non-electrolytes here. So for you all these no need, just remember glucose, sucrose and urea. Okay, generally you will come across these examples. So sucrose, glucose, urea, these are the examples for the non-electrolytes. Now here the scientist called Faraday, okay, he classified the electrolytes into strong and weak electrolyte. Okay, so what is the strong and weak electrolyte means? Here strong electrolytes on dissolution in water are ionized almost completely, okay, while the weak electrolyte are only partially dissociate. Okay, what is the meaning of this one means? Here if you see example, we have an aqueous solution of sodium chloride means what? Here we have the, okay, here we have the sodium chloride, you are going to dissolve in the water, that is called as a what? Aqueous solution. Okay, so what happened is comprised entirely, okay, entirely sodium ions, that is Na plus, and chloride ion, that is what? Cl minus. Okay, while that of acetic acid mainly contain unionized acetic acid molecules and only some acetate ions means what? Here the formula of acetate ion means what? CH3COO minus, and you have the hydronium ion, nothing but H plus. Through both of them are polar molecules. So what is the meaning of this one means here? So here if you take, okay, One, when you take the sodium chloride, okay, here I am taking the sodium chloride, okay, the sodium chloride I am going to dissolve in the water, okay. So what happened? This solution contain almost Na plus and Cl minus. For example, I took the 100 chloride ions. So what happened? You are going to get the 100 Na plus ions and 100 Cl minus ions. Okay. So here we are taking the in beaker. Okay. We are going to add the NaCl. So for example, you are taking the 100 molecules of NaCl means in the aqua solution means what? Here we have the water. Okay. This is a solvent. What we have? Water. In this you have Na plus and Cl minus means here how many? You have 100 Na plus ions, 100 Cl minus ions. Okay, nothing but it is what? Completely ionized. Completely. Okay, ionization happened what? Completely. Okay, you have the complete ionization is there. Okay, now in the same thing, if you take the again, now I am taking the acetic acid. Okay, acetic acid. So acetic acid means formula CH3COH. When again you are going to dissolve in the water, again we are taking the what solvent here? Water. So here if you take here, it is going to ionize as a what? CH3CO minus, that is called acetate ion along with the H plus. Now in this case what happened? If you take the 100 acetate ion, okay, you are going to get the 10 acetate ions, 10 H plus ions. Okay, means what? Only few molecules are dissociate, means here there is a equilibrium, means you have unionized acetic acid along with the acetate and H plus ion. So now what is the reason here? Means both are you are going to add in the water only, but here complete ionization took place in case of sodium chloride, but in case of acetate what happened? Only few molecules only ionized. Okay, but let's see what is the reason for this. Now if you see that reason, what is there? The extent to which the ionization occur depends on here. First I will go for this point. This is because there is almost 100% ionization in case of sodium chloride, okay, as compared to less than only 5% ionization of acetic acid, which is a weak electrolyte. Here you are going to decide what based on the strength of bond. Sodium chloride is a strong electrolyte, means going to ionize completely 100%, means if you are taking the 100 molecules, it's going to dissociate what? 100 Na plus 100 Cl minus ions. But in case of what happened, acetic acid only 5% is, means you are taking the, for example, 100 molecules, only what happened among that only 5 molecules are ionized. Okay, why? Because me it is a weak electrolyte. Now come to the reason why it is happening like this, means the extent to which ionization occur depends on the strength of bond and the extent of solvation of ions produced. Here the strength of bond means if a bond is strong, it is going to dissociate completely. If bond is weak, it is going to dissociate slightly. Okay, first reason is this one. Second reason is what? The extent of solvation of ions means what? Here solvation means here, for example, once the sodium chloride added in the water, it is going to dissociate what? Na plus Cl minus, isn't it? So around here what happened? Cation water, for example, water I took the solvent, okay. So what happened? Around a cation, water molecule going to be surrounded. Around anion, water molecule going to be surrounded. That is called what? Solvation, okay. Solvation of ions means ion, what are the produce? They are surrounded by the solvent molecule, that is called as a solvation of ions. So here the ionization depends on the strength of the bond and the solvation of ions produced. So here what happened next? It should be noted that in case of weak electrolyte, okay, for example, we took acetic acid. Equilibrium is established between the ions and unionized molecule. This type of equilibrium involving the ions in aqueous solution is called ionic equilibrium. Ionic equilibrium means what? Simply what I told, acetic acid is there, okay? Acetic acid is there, okay? I will go for the. Okay, here we have what we told. Okay, acetic acid is a weak electrolyte. Why? Because means it does not undergo complete ionization. So here you are going to get the acetate ion, okay, along with the what? H plus. Okay, so why? Because means if you take the 100 molecules, in that only 5 you are going to get the acetate ion, 5 H plus ion. Means what? In 100 only 5 acetic acid molecules are dissociated what? Acetate ion and H plus ion. So what happened? There is a equilibrium between the what? Unionized molecule and ionized ions. Okay, ions and unionized molecule. This type of equilibrium called as a what? Ionic equilibrium. This type is called as a what? Ionic. This type of equilibrium. As we told, in equilibrium we should have reactant and product. Okay. So here we have the ions in the equilibrium. This type of equilibrium called as a what? Ionic equilibrium. Now in case of sodium chloride, what happened in here? Sodium chloride, in if you take the 100 molecules, what happened? It is going to dissociate as a what? Na plus and Cl minus. Means you are going to get the 100 Na plus ion, 100 Cl minus ion. So there is no equilibrium. Why? Because mean equilibrium means you should have the reactant and product. But what happened here? Totally reactants are converted into products. So there is no equilibrium. So this type of electrolytes called as a what? Strong electrolytes. This I mean sodium. If complete ionization takes place, it is called as a what? Strong electrolytes. If complete ionization does not take place, that are called as a what? Weak electrolyte. Now acetic acid is what? Weak electrolyte. Okay. So this is the concept of weak electrolyte and strong electrolytes. Okay, next if you see the case of sodium chloride, what happened? It exists in solid state as a cluster of positively charged sodium ions and negatively charged chloride ions, which are held together due to electrostatic interaction between the oppositely charged species. Here what happened if you see the sodium chloride crystal, okay? It is generally called as a rock salt. You can see here sodium chloride and Cl minus having the oppositely charged with the what? With the electrostatic interaction, nothing but simply you call as a what? Ionic bond. Okay. So here we are having the oppositely charged ions are attached with the what? Electrostatic interaction. Okay. Now the electrostatic forces between the two charges are inversely proportional to what? Dielectric constant of the medium. Okay. So here you see electro here important what? Electrostatic attraction forces are what? Inversely proportional to what? Dielectric constant. Okay. So water is a universal solvent. As you know, where generally we are taking the water as a universal solvent, it possesses the high dielectric constant what? 80. Okay. Now so what happened? Once the sodium chloride, okay, thus when sodium chloride is dissolved in the water, the electrostatic interactions are reduced by factor 80, and this facilitate the ions to move freely in the solution. Also they are well separated due to hydration with the water molecule. Now here what is happening means, once if you dissolve in the water, what is happening means sodium chloride, once you dissolve in the water here, okay. So first it's in the solid state. Slowly what happened, you can see here Cl minus ion came in, Na plus ion came out. Okay. So why? Because means once dissolved in the water, what we told here, electrostatic attraction forces are inversely proportional to dielectric constant. Okay. So dielectric constant of water is very high. How much we have? 80. Okay. Once dissolved in the water, that many factor what happened? Electrostatic attraction, nothing but interaction, is going to reduce. Because of this reduction, what happened? The sodium chloride, what we have, the crystal structure is going to dissociate as a what? Na plus and Cl minus ion. First reason. And second reason is what happened? Once our ions are coming around it, water molecules are surrounded. That is called what? Solvation. Nothing but hydration. Nothing but whatever. Hydra means nothing but water. So these ions are surrounded by the water molecule. Here we given dissolution of sodium chloride in water, Na plus Cl minus ions are established by their hydration with the polar water molecule. Simply what happened? It is going to then dissociate as our Na plus Cl minus ions. Why? Because means because water having the high dielectric constant, once dissolving in the water, electrostatic attraction forces are reduced by factor 80. Okay, because of that reason, it is dissociated as our Na plus Cl minus ions. Let us see the examples further here. Strong electrolytes, sodium hydroxide, HCl and H2SO4. Weak electrolyte, acetic acid and ammonium hydroxide. Okay, these examples you better to remember. Next here we have two terminology, dissociation, ionization. Okay, both are similar but we have slight difference. What is that? Let us see here. Dissociation refers to the what? Process of separation of ions in water already existing as such in the solid state of the solute, as in sodium chloride. Here what we have, sodium chloride already we discussed, it is having the what? Weak electrostatic attraction forces and it exists as about ions. One dissolved in the water, what happens, is going to separate as a Na plus Cl minus ions. Means already in the solid state, what happened, exist as a what? It is already in the ion state. One dissolved in the water, it's going to separate as about Na plus Cl minus ion. That process called about dissociation. Sorry, not the dissolution, this is a dissociation. Next we have the ionization. Ionization means what? Corresponding to a process in which neutral molecule, okay, split into charged ions. For example, here what happened? Acetic acid is there, okay. Before itself, we don't have any charge. That is called as a neutral molecule. So, one dissolved in the water, what happened? It is going to dissociate as a CH3CO minus acetate ion and H+. This is called as a ionization, okay. So, in dissociation means what happened? Already we have charges in the molecule. But in case of ionization, what happened? We have the neutral molecule. It is going to dissociate what? Cation and anion. That is called as what? Ionization. Here, we shall not distinguish between the two and use the two terms interchangeably. So, there is no difference. We are not going to differentiate. Simply, we are using dissociation and ionization as the same terminology. Now, to discuss ionic equilibrium, already we discussed, okay, in solution. So, ionic equilibrium is a state of equilibrium set up between the ionized and unionized molecule. For example, just now we saw acetic acid is what? Here, unionized molecule, okay. It is a weak electrolyte, ionized as a what? Acetic acid, acetate ion and H+ ion. This type of, okay, here if you see, this is unionized molecule, this is ionized ions. This type of equilibrium is called as a what? Ionic equilibrium, okay. In weak electrolyte, equilibrium is established between the ions and unionized molecule. So, if it is strong, means what happened? Reactants are converted into product. So, in case of, we are discussing the equilibrium, ionic equilibrium, but in case of weak electrolyte only, not strong electrolyte, okay. In weak electrolytes, there is a equilibrium between the unionized and ionized ions, okay. This type of equilibrium ions in aqueous solution is called ionic equilibrium. Means if you take in the water as a solvent, that is called as a what? Ionic equilibrium in the aqueous solution or solution. Let us see the example. Here we have the H+, you are going to dissolve in the water. So, it's going to get your what? H+ and X-. Here we have the X, okay. Make it correction, it's X-. So, equilibrium means you can write the equilibrium constant. K means what? Mole product of molar concentration of product to reactant, okay. So, we have the H+, X- are the product and reactant. So, let us see the second example. Here we have the Fe+, Sc thiocyanate ion gives rise to complex. Okay, now if you write the equilibrium, product with the what? Reactant. Product of molar concentration of reactant. So, these are the reactant. These are the product. So, this is about the what? Ionic equilibrium. Okay.